to walk into that building, you just knew it's us. Pasifika, Te Moana Nui, Akiwa, us.
You could go to the Consulate General, get your passport done. You could go to the dentist. There was a little cafe there. It was the beating heart for our people.
More recently, with the whole gentrification, the whole movement of Pacific communities out of inner city Auckland, it can be felt that it's missing its people.
That's fundamentally the question to pose back to the community, back to the government. What is this building? And what's it for now?
I've been obsessed with the building for ages. I used to live on Kay Road. So I'd walk past and it'd be like, Samoa House, what is that? It looks completely different from every other building. It says Samoa, we're Samoan.
Walking down like Kay Road, you just see that Ma'ota Samoa sign. I had no idea that the Fale was even in there. Coming here felt like more of a connection to my grandparents.
I still get people coming all the way up the stairs and being like, oh, I want to learn more about my heritage. Is this the place to come to? It's just quite confronting because it's like, oh, this isn't the consulate anymore.
Historically, this is the first Ma'ota to be built outside of Samoa. And you have a sense of the alofa, you have a sense of the spirit, you have a sense of the people's dreams, you have a sense that this is a place where things will happen for your future.
Basically, Dad ended up with a bunch of documents that belonged to my grandfather. One thing I've got here, it's a typed script for a speech. My speech before launching fundraising for the Samoa House, now standing at Karangahape Road. The reasons for wanting to erect a modern building are to lift up our people in education, physical and spiritual. Do you think as a New Zealand citizen and a Samoan, to see our people in desperate plight, that it doesn't concern us? This other part that you said reminded you of him. If we are waiting for the right person or persons to come along, nothing will ever happen.
It's kind of the opposite to what Polynesians would do generally, which is to put yourself out into the open and speaking openly against, you know, some of the things that were happening. I feel quite proud of my dad that he did that.
Highest ranked of income or paramount of each city would sit on the round edge.
The struggle that the community, especially the inner city community, went through in the 1960s, 70s, and 80s. A lot of those people who were quite seminal in building this were fighting that struggle. That got woven into the genealogy and the stories that went on in this building. For me, the architecture is only the apparatus or the thing that structures our lives and hold our stories. People come and go and they would leave stories that would be embedded in the building. And you can't just get rid of the structure, you get rid of the structure, you destroy those stories and those vile linkages to what happen with our community here in their struggle to find their own self-identity.
It's obviously necessary for any country that does not have...
The Prime Minister, Robert Muldoon, the driver of the Dawn Raids, the overstays, the very same man is then given the opportunity to open Ma'ota Samoa. Our parents were giggling because they saw an irony here. They saw that this is the man that harassed Pacific people, and at the same time, he's having to open a building that symbolizes the presence and contribution of Pacific Nations people.
So we're in Karangahape Road, And we've just come off from the Ponsonby Road intersection. And so back in the days, in the 60s and 70s, this is the road. It's a spiritually, culturally exciting road to be on. And all our grandfathers, parents, at the peak of their youthfulness. They're the exciting young people that are going to make changes, contributions. So we see a connection from the 70s, but it's now 2023. Where's our history? Where's our presence? And so the Maota Project becomes a very vital link of that healing, of that our sovereignty, of our who we are.
Look at all these paintings! Oh my gosh, it's moldy. Oh no. Oh my god, it's in the toilet.
Is it a toilet?
It's a toilet full of art. This is quite sad, eh?
Yeah.
Do the Samoan consulate know that these are here? Okay, so in 2016, the Samoan Consulate moved out to Mangere, to Beta Drive. And it kind of feels like they really left quick.
Because at the moment, we don't have access. And that is one of the core problems. To get access, we have to go through a palangi company who owns the lease of this space and pay for this access of something that was built for us.
I get emails every day asking us if Samoan organisations and Pacific Island organisations can use the Fale. I want to say yes. Absolutely. Immediately, this is what the Fale was made for, because that's what we've understood through our historical research. But I'm not in charge of who gets access to that Fale and who gets access to this building. And the people that are in charge of who gets access to the Fale quite often are saying, sorry.
I think what we want is it to be back as it was intended when it was opened in 1979. And we need to educate. And actually, what's happening now, that nobody will realise, they won't know.
Yeah, but I also think the awareness that we're still here.
Yeah.
And we still want to connect with this, and we still want to have access, and we still want to utilise this place for education. We could have our health services, we can have education, we could have multiple things here. We could have arts, we could have shows, we could have celebrations.
You've got to remember that a lot of the funds that allow for the complex to be built were raised by the local Samoan community here in inner city Auckland. The consulate and the Samoan government, they own the property, but the important historical cultural belonging is with the community and some of the very personal connection to the community.
I haven't been there for years, and I was shocked when I went in and saw, with great sadness, the decline of the building.
I find it very difficult to understand where we fit when it was built for us and by our people for us.
It is a shame for it just to sort of fade away and be left to whoever, whatever, when there is so much potential, even just for younger generations to even just be aware that it exists and, like, this was actually made by your ancestors.
That's why it's really important that we move quickly to restore the mana of this Fale again.
I would love to take my children up there to tell the history of our people of Kay Road in Maota Samoa. I think for us is the hope that one day it can be recognised for the historically significant heartbeat and home that it was, and that it can still be.
And as the migration out of inner city Auckland began to happen, we then begin to see that our presence is becoming invisible. And so what we see is all of a sudden this push to push our people out into South Auckland. We see this push of taking away our presence on this road, and we begin to see that we're becoming invisible.